Hello. Today we're going to take a fairly deep dive into how the Y86 CPU works. And there are going to be a lot of details, but the reward is that you'll finally understand how the complete CPU works. And it will also help a lot as you work on Project 4. All right, so we're going to talk about something today called semantics. Semantics refers to the study of meaning, and what we're concerned about is the meaning of a particular Y86 instruction. What does an instruction mean? For us, the meaning of an instruction is what effect does it have on the machine? What's going on in the underlying circuits? And in order to talk about this, we need to be able to understand the purpose and the action of all the stages of a Y86 CPU. So here on the right, you can see a picture of the complete circuit diagram for Y86. You can't read any of the individual pieces, but we've seen some of these before, and we'll look at these again here in just a moment. So what we're going to talk about is how these different components work in the six stages of the Y86 CPU. So those six stages are fetch, decode, execute, memory, write back, and PC update. And so we'll talk about what each of these components are doing in each of these phases, and then we'll take a look at these semantics that are written at the bottom of your Y86 reference sheet. So you'll see a bunch of boxes where we have the name of an instruction. So this one is IR move Q. And then we have a little section for each of the six stages. And the text inside of each of these stages tells you what the machine is doing during that particular stage for that particular instruction. You'll notice that some of these regions are empty. For example, the decode region for the IR move Q instruction has nothing in it. That just means that that particular portion of the CPU isn't really doing much during that phase. It's just propagating signals from the other phases. As you might guess, the reason that the decode phase is empty here for IR move Q is because the decode phase has to do with reading registers, and the IR move Q instruction doesn't read any registers. All right, so that's what we're going to spend the rest of our time doing, is talking about the individual components inside the CPU, how they fit into these stages, and then we'll talk about working through these semantics for some concrete instructions.